want to get right to some of the, you're going to be running the Falmouth Road Race up there, and you're also doing a triathlon. Being in space for a prolonged period of time, tough on your body. So in an effort to combat those negative effects, that's really why you want to be doing this triathlon in space. How's the training going? When is the triathlon? And how do you swim?
Well, I'm happy this time to be participating in the road race. It's just over 7 miles. It has a long history. This year's its 40th reunion, and also the triathlon with Dr. Sanjay Gupta, and that's in September. So one in August and one in September. I've been up here for 2 weeks now. I've been working out on the bike, which is right in front of me, also the treadmill, which is around the corner, and the advanced resistive exercise device, which is a weightlifting machine based on vacuum that we're pushing against the vacuums in a canister. The A-Red is new since I was here last time. The treadmill is a new treadmill with a wider base. So those two pieces of equipment are a huge upgrade since I was here last time. And so we've been working out on those two pieces of equipment pretty heavily. I'm doing an interesting exercise protocol. It's an experiment. It's called Sprint. And so it does have us doing sprints on the treadmill and pretty much trying to max out on your lifting. So for this first 2 weeks, it's been tough. Microgravity is nice to your body. You can float around. It feels good. But when you simulate gravity, when you're on either the treadmill or the A-Red, it sort of hurts. And so it's been a bit of an adjustment to get into the exercise. But I think by a couple weeks for the road race, I'll be ready. I've ran up to 5 miles continuously now, and I think I'll be ready for the triathlon for sure.
Well, that's a perfect transition, being physically ready, because you and I also have decided to do this triathlon together, mid-September, the Malibu Nautica Triathlon. You're going to do it in space. I'm going to do it on Earth. And again, it was one of the most fascinating things for me to watch you train on Earth. And you've done the Boston Marathon before from space, back in 2007, I believe. How is your training going? What's it like up there?
Well, you know, the adaptation is great for space. You know, up here everything feels a little bit easier. You know, you just saw Aki floating by. It just takes one hand to move yourself. But then when you start simulating gravity, when you get on the treadmill, you have a harness on that's pulling you down, or you get on the weightlifting machine and you're actually doing squats and deadlifts against a weight based on vacuum, it hurts. So this first 2 weeks we've sort of used as just get used to the equipment, get used to the protocols that we're doing. So I think we're at that point that we're finally adapted and ready to start building on it. So just watch out, because I'm ready to really start preparing for the triathlon. And watching the Olympics up here has been really motivating to turn us all into really good athletes.
Right. No, I better watch what I say here. If I get beat by you up in space, but you are going 17,000 miles an hour, so you do have that going for you. You have the bike, I believe, right? I mean, can you just quickly show us how you do this?
Sure. I was talking about the bike when you were visiting us before, because luckily here in space, we don't need a seat. All we do is put our feet in the pedals, and I'll demonstrate here. Sort of ready to go.
So
you don't have to sit down. You just start. This
is amazing. You're literally.
We have a machine here, a computer that we can program in the amount of. Resistance.
And station this Houston ACR. Check that your mic is on.
Sorry about that. In the floating, it got turned off. So we also have a computer here that we can dial in the resistance and the speed, and then we also, just for health purposes, take our heart rate as we're riding. And so we can. This is how I'm going to simulate the bike ride. So for the hills, I can increase my resistance to match the route that you're going to take, because I would assume that Malibu is not flat. Like Houston, right?
Not flat, right. So I want you to increase that resistance quite high, I think, for this.
quite high, I think.
I don't know if you can still hear me, Sunny, but you were saying you had to just get used to doing this. Does it hurt your knees? Because you don't have, like, you think about having some gravity to help force your legs through the revolutions riding a bike. I mean, does it hurt the joints when you're doing it this way?
No, you know, surprisingly enough, the bike for me is really good for your thighs and also cardiovascular. As soon as I start increasing the resistance on the bike, I think the cardiovascular part sort of starts to take over for me. So that, you know, the knees are not a problem at all. I think we get a really good knee and leg workout all for our joints, particularly our hips, our knees, and our ankles on the advanced resistive exercise device, and that's what that's made for. You know, up here, of course, we lose muscle mass and bone density just instantaneously as every day because we're not under the influence of gravity, and so we definitely need some type of loading on those parts of our body. And the A-Red does that, and also the treadmill does that as you run, and then you come down and put your foot flat on the treadmill as you're running. So both of those things are good for the bone mass and the muscle mass and bone density. But this guy for sure is good for cardiovascular.